No woman should be forced to marry someone whom she does not like or she does not prefer just because her parents or her family want such a marriage. She has the full right to say no. And in this case, the marriage cannot be made unless she her full consent and in a free way is fulfilled. So any sort of making such marriages by force or by pressure are against Islam.
There is nothing like forced and arranged marriages in Islam. It was done out of, you know, the cultural understanding. But as to the Islamic principles, we should ask the woman, we should ask the girl what she wants to do, and if she says no, it's no. And we had an example, a very young woman came to the Prophet and asked him, you know, my father married me to this man without asking me. The first question of the Prophet was, do you want to divorce? Do you want me to separate you from him? She said, no, I'm fine. I just wanted the fathers to know that it's not of their business. That's it. It's clear. There is no discussion about it. So we have to deal with that and to say it's not acceptable. And we have to condemn it.
Islam doesn't say anything about forced or arranged marriages in the sense of yes or no. But Islamic law developed a huge code of practice about getting a female consent in marriage. And that without an adult consent, without both parties consenting to a marriage, in some areas of Islamic law, marriage wasn't even considered valid. So what we really have is a huge cultural tradition where women were denied access to consenting and married by their guardians or their parents. And within many cultures, this still exists. But what we're now also seeing that women are asserting that this is a right given to them by religion itself, by the Quran itself, or by Islamic law, that without their consent, the marriage cannot be valid. So without a female consent, if the marriage isn't valid, the marriage can't possibly be valid if it's just forced.
The Prophet, peace be upon him, on more than occasion, when he was told by, adult girl that her father actually is obliging her to marry a person whom she does not really love and accept. And the Prophet advised her, to accept the proposal of her father, but she refused. And she refused that repeatedly. Then the Prophet said to her, fine, you are free to enter into this marriage or not. Then after giving that answer by the Prophet, the girl said, okay, Prophet, I will accept the suggestion of my father, but I wanted to make the point that the father or the guardian has no right to compel me or to abrogate my choice in joining my future partner. However, I'll accept what my father has done. And so the freedom of choice, of your partner on life journey, is very important, because it is me and her who are going to live together, not my father or her father or my mother or her mother. That is our life, and we have to, although we seek the blessing of the elderly and their wisdom and so on, and we try to make both families are happy and enjoying our happiness together, but there is a limit for what we can accept from the interference of other people.
Obedience to parents, strictly speaking, is heavily emphasized in the Quran. And when I say heavily, I really mean that, it's something that's actually noted in the Quran. Do not disobey your parents. Having said all that, children are also seen as a trial for parents themselves in the Quran. And the relationship is really one of tension, that whereas there is obedience is emphasized, there's also this underlying tension that there has to be mutual respect on both sides. So I would argue that most people who wish to go against the wishes of their parents will really need to sit down and want and think and talk as to what it is that their parents are doing that is making them either rebel or disobey, as opposed to running away from the problem. Most cultures do not allow, most Muslim cultures do not allow for space outside the family or the extended family system or the community. So if you run away, what are you running to and what are you running away from? And I think that we are now living in societies where people are simply not being given the freedom to think and express and are being coerced into issues that really should have been debated within the family structure from a very early age, as opposed to something that comes about when a child reaches, you know, the later teens or early 20s or 30s.